नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये
गजाननं भूतगणातिसेवितं कवित्तजम्बूफलदारभक्षितं उमात्रं रोगविनाशकारणं नमामि विघ्नेश्वरपादपङ्कजम् आपदां भक्तारं दातारं सर्वसम्पदां कृपाविरामं श्रीरामं भूयो भूयो नमाम्यहं भक्तानामात्यन्तारं भीतानां भयनाशनं दशतां कालदण्डं तं रामचन्द्रं नमाम्यहं रामाय रामभद्राय रामचन्द्राय वेदसे रघुनाथाय नाथाय सीताय रामते नमः उजन्तं राम रामेति मधुरं मधुराक्षरम् आरोग्य कविता शाखा वन्दे वाल्मीकिकोकिलं वाल्मीके मुनिसिंहस्य कवितावनचारिणः शृण्वन् रामकथानादं कोनियादिपदाङ्गतिं पुष्पदीकृतवाणीशं मषकीकृतराक्षसं रामायणमहामाला रत्नं वन्दे निलात्मजम् अञ्जनानन्दनं वीरं जानकीशोकनाशनं कपीशमक्षहन्तारं वन्दे लङ्काभयङ्करम् भवन अमंगल हारी मंगल भवन अमंगल हारी द्रो सुरशिरत अजिर हारी द्रो सुदशिरत अजिर बिहारी हनुमान गोसाई जे 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 हनुमान गोसाई कृपा करो गुरु देव की नाई कृपा करो गुरु देव की नाई जे 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 हनुमान गोसाई मंगल भवन अमंगल हारी जनक सुता जग जननी जानकी अतिशय प्रिय करुणा निधान की ताके जुगपद कमल मना जास कृपा निर्मल मति पाऊं सो वी वर इन द बैटल हैपनिंग इन कैलासा रीजन बिटवीन रावणा एंड हिज एल्डर ब्रदर वैश्रवण कुबेरा We saw last time that Kubera had sent a messenger to Lanka and the conversation between the messenger and Ravana at the end of which Ravana had beheaded the messenger given him to the Rakshasas to be for food. And then he had immediately taken off along with his ministers and his army north to invade Kubera himself, and he had arrived there at the massive battle between Kubera's army and Ravana's army, and then finally Kubera himself had stepped down to battle with Ravana. He had come accompanied by his Shankha and Padma Nidhis. And we concluded last time with the little description of Kubera from mythology as well as the oft-heard mantra Raja Adi Raja Aya Pradakya Rakhne Kubera Aya Vaishrava Aya. The Shankha Nidhi and Padma Nidhi are one of the nine two of the nine nidhis of Kubera, the treasures, the guardians of treasures, they take a human form to come with Kubera when he has come out to fight with Ravana. If you go to, when you go to Tirumala temple in Lord Venkateshwara temple, you will find in one of the enclosures will be guarded by Padmanidhi and Shankaridhi. They guard the treasures of Lord Venkateshwara. Now the brothers are face to face. There is a battle due. But however the younger brother may be, the elder brother knew that he cannot lose his dignity when he is communicating with cruel Ravana. Although Ravana, by reason of curse, he knew that Ravana, by reason of curse, is incapable of behaving in a proper manner. But Kubera himself is a venerable one, so he addressed him in a manner worthy of someone born in the lineage of Brahma. So when we speak in a manner worthy of being born in that lineage. So like that Kubera spoke. In some sense, if you speak ill, then you are bringing down the lineage. So he spoke well. So he said, told Ravana, since you will not see despite my warnings what your misdeeds will result in, you will realize it too late. You fool. When you have reaped the fruit of what you do and you find yourself in hell, then start a small 7-8 verses of Upadesha from Kubera to Ravana, which can probably be called as Kubera Gita, if you may. It's not that anybody else has called it, but it's a Dharma Upadesha, so I'm mentioning that in that form. So he says it. He tells Ravana, Yohi moha visham pitva navagacchati durmati satasya parinamante jani de karmana phalam. Yohi moha visham pitva navagacchati durmati. The durmati, the fool who, because of delusion, drinks poison, he will not know what he has done until suddenly it has done its work. Devatani nandanti dharma yukte na kena jit yena tvam nidrusham bhavam nitas tachana buddhyase. Brother, the gods, devatas, have not had a single opportunity to praise you for any act of dharma that you have done. Because of which they have turned their faces away from you. And because they have turned their faces away from you, that you, being guilty of such horrible sin, you do not know what you have done. Meaning to say, I presume, that if some dharma yukta karyam is done, then there is an occasion for the devatas to like it. If they like it and they are happy, then when some adharma yukta karyam is done by you, they will reprimand you, because of which you will know that I have done something wrong. Therefore, there is a chance of some, you can come out of it. But if you don't do any dharma, they turn their face, then you do adharma also, you don't know that you have done it. You don't know what you have done. Mataram pitaram yohi acharyam chava manyate sapashyati phalantasya pretaradiva shangata. The person who avamanyate, who treats, humiliates or treats with scorn or disrespectfully treats his mother or father or acharya, he will reap the fruit, he will see the fruit when he is hauled up before Pretaraja, when he is hauled up before the Lord of the departed spirits, when he comes under the control, Pretaraja Vashamgata, when he is caught by the Pretaraja, then he will understand what is the fruit of having treated with scorn his mother or father or acharya. Adhruve sarire yo nakaroti taporjanam sapaccha tapyate mudho mruto gatvatmano gatim. Adhruve sarire, this body which is not permanent, here today, gone tomorrow. Acharya Shankara says in Bhajagovindam, Kala Kridati Gachati Ayu. Adhruve Sarire, in this for impermanent body, he who does not earn merit through tapasya, who does not make a balance of tapas, sapascha tapyate, he later suffers, mudho, the idiot, suffers. When he dies and sees where he is headed, dharmad rajyam dhanam saukhyam adharmad dukkham eva cha tasmad dharmam sukarthaya kuryat papam visarjayet. It is from dharma that rajyam dhanam saukhyam, rulership, wealth, happiness, all comes from dharma. Well, adharma brings dukkha meva cha, only sorrow. Therefore, he who wishes for happiness, he should garner dharma and he should abandon adharma. Pāpasya phalam dukkham tat bhoktavyam yātmanā taspāt pātmā pagātārtham mūdham pāpa karishyati. Pāpasya phalam dukkham. Sorrow is but the result of sin, and that has to be experienced in this world by oneself. Therefore, if a fool sins, he is doing so for his own undoing, for his own harm only he is doing it. Atma apaghartha. The fool does not acquire this wisdom by, he does not acquire wisdom by thinking about what he is doing, etc. He simply does something wrong and then he reaps the fruits of what he has sown. Riddhim rupam balam putra vittam shuratvam eva cha praptumanti nara loke nirjitam punya karma bihi. Riddhim, prosperity, rupam, beauty, balam, strength, putran, chitaram, progeny, vittam, suratvam, wealth, valor, all these are fruits of good deeds. Your mind being perverted, for 10-headed one, you will go to hell surely. Natvam samibhashishye sadhruteshveva nirnaya. Natvam samibhashishye. I don't want to engage you in further conversation. That is the rule that those of high conduct follow. There's no point wasting words with you. I have told you, I wasted some words on you, but no more. And then he attacked Ravana's army. He attacked Maricha and the rest, and such was his terrific attack that they fled, unable to stand against Kubera. And he struck Dashagriva on his head with his gada, with his mace, terrifically. Dashagriva withstood that. He was not dislodged by the attack of the mace on his head. And they were fighting furiously, and neither of them, neither the Yaksha nor the Rakshasa, was feeling the least bit tired or fatigued or dazed or anything. They were going on fighting furiously. They were using astras against each other. Kubera used the Agni Astra against Ravana. Ravana stopped it with Varuna Astra. Like that they were going on. And then Ravana suddenly created a magic screen. And hiding behind the magic screen, he created hundreds of forms of himself. He created 1,000 phantom shapes to battle with Kubera. He appeared himself in various disguises, like tiger, like boar, like clouds. Suddenly tiger will be attacking. Suddenly when cloud will come and start pouring heavily on him from all sides, cover him up. There will be a mountain suddenly in front of him. A sea will be suddenly surging towards him. Tree will fall on him from all sorts of places. Yakshas, daityas, he converted himself to thousands of phantom forms. None of which was himself, but they were all phantom, and he was attacking him from all sides. And then he armed himself with a great weapon and stealth. With stealth he came upon Kubera and he struck him badly on his head, and at that blow lot of wealth just reeled and he fell down and he was bathed in blood like an Ashoka tree which has been axed. He fell. Many a phantom, and he could not be seen, and then he came and he attacked Kubera, and then Kubera had fallen, and he had been defeated, and the king of Rakshasas was delighted. And Kubera's deities, the ones who preside, the Shankhanidhi and Padmanidhi, who guard the treasures, who attended upon Kubera, they quickly picked him up and they brought him off to Nandana to revive him. They took him away. And Ravana was now, he had defeated Kubera, and then as a token of his victory, he seized the Pushpaka Vimana. Kanchanastambha Samvedam Vaidhuryamanitoranam Mukta Jala Pratishchinnam Sarvakama Palasumam. Golden pillars. It had arches decorated with lapis lazuli. It had, for curtains, it had ropes of pearls. Ambalpam will be 611 pearls. Ropes of pearls. Ropes of pearls for curtains. It had sarvakama phaladrumam. It had trees which would give fruits in all seasons, whatever fruit you want. Sarvakama phaladrumam. Manojavam kamagamam kamarupam vihangamam manikanchana sopanam taptakanchana vedikam. Manojavam. It could move with the speed of the mind. Kamagamam. Wherever you want to go, it could go. Kamarupam, take any shape you want. Vihangamam, fly like a bird. Manikanchana Sopanam, it had steps made of diamonds and gold. Manikanchana Sopanam. Taptakanchana Vedikam. And it had seats which are made of burnt gold, burnished gold. It had gods for bearers. It's a constant delight to the mind and eye. It's so beautiful. It had various apartments inside, suitably designed. It's a marvel that nothing could destroy it. It was indestructible. It was fashioned by Vishwakarma. It was furnished with all that the heart could desire. Everything was there. It had no equal. That Pushpaka Vimana he took. One more thing, Agastya tells Rama about that Pushpaka Vimana. Natu sheetam natu ushnam cha sarvartu sukadam shubham satam raja samarukhya kamakam veere nirjitam. Natu sheetam natu ushnam. It was neither too cool, it was not too hot. It was just the right temperature inside all the time. Sarvartu sukadam shubham. In all ritus, in all the seasons, sukadam was pleasant, shubham auspicious, everything inside was nice. The king Dashananda, he climbed into that Pushpaka Vimanam which he had won by his valor. He started riding a superb car, wanted to go to Lanka. He went to Lanka, he went to his audience chamber, he sat down there like a victorious king, etc. And then he had this. Now he had this Pushpaka Vimana too. So he started going here and there, and that Pushpaka Vimana. Kimbaka nowadays is sleeping. He's going here and there. Sajitva dhanadam rama bhrataram rakshasadipa mahasena prasutim tadjayau sharavanam mahate athapashyat dashagriyo rupum sharavanam mahate gabastijalatam vitam tujiyame ubhaskadam. So he was flying in the Pushpaka Vimana once, having vanquished his brother, O Rama, he was flying in this Pushpaka Vimana and he saw below him the great forest of reeds, the Sharavanam, where Mahasena Prasutim, the supreme commander, Guha was born. He saw that Sharavanam, beautiful forest of golden reeds, which looked Gamasti Jala Samvitam Dityam Yubhaskaram. It looked like a dense mass of golden rays. It looked like the second sun. Saw that in the sky. And he was flying over it towards the mountain in front, which was next to that Sharavana. And his Pushpaka Vimana stopped in midair. It was just immobilized suddenly. Vistabdham kimidam kasmad agamat kamagam kritam achintayat rakshasendra sachivaishtai samavrata. Kamagam, this is supposed to go where I wish, I thought, and it is not. Why is it so? Wondered Ravana, what has happened? Along with the ministers, they were all a bit bewildered. It has been suddenly immobilized in midair. Karmedam kashtachit bhavet. Why doesn't the Pushpaka go as I wish? Someone must be responsible for this. Someone perhaps in this mountain was responsible for this. Who could have done this? Whose karma is this? Who has done this? And Ravana and the ministers. And Maricha, who is this? Maricha is called the sagacious minister of Ravana. He talks sense to Ravana. He always talks sense, but he doesn't listen. But he's got. So Ravana says there must be some reason why the Pushpaka does not move, O king. Perhaps it may be that it does not want, it will not carry anybody other than Kubera. It is possible that it may be perhaps programmed or whatever. That it does not carry someone other than Kubera because it has been taken away from, maybe stop moving.
इति वाक्यांतरे तस्य करालः कृष्णपिङ्गलः वामनो विकटो मुण्डी नन्दी ह्रस्वभुजो बली ततः पार्श्वमुपागम्य भवस्यानुचरो ब्रवीत् नन्दीश्वरो वचश्चेदं राक्षसेन्द्रं शङ्कितः. When Maricha was saying this, suddenly there appeared in front of them a frightful appearance with dark red eyes, a dwarf Vamana. Short, vikato, frightful, hideous in appearance, mundi, shaven head, hrasvabhujo, short arms, bali, very strong. Ok,
came nearby. Who was he? Bhavasti Anujaro. He was the attendant of Lord Shiva, Nandishwara. He came and fearlessly spoke to Ravana. Told him, Nivartasva, go back. Nivartasva Rasha Griva, go back, O ten-headed man. Shailaya Krigati Shankara. Shankara is sporting in this mountain. It is out of bounds for Suparnas, Nagas, Yakshas, God, Gandharvas, Rakshasas. It is out of bounds for all creatures. These words, Ravana doesn't hear such words from people. He was roused to wrath when he heard, go back. Krodha Kampita Kundala. He got down and his earrings were quaking in anger. Since Kampita Kundala, quaking in anger. Rosha Tamranayana. His anger, his eyes are becoming red in Rosham. He got down and he asked, Oyam Shankara. Who is this Shankara? Saying this, he just drove towards that mountain in front, which he had been told that you dare not, nobody can go there. He just drove towards it. So pashyan nandinam tatra devasya durtah sthitam deeptam shoolam avashtabhyat dvitiya bhaya shankaram. And when he was there, when he went there, suddenly again he found Nandi. And Nandi was leaning on a blazing spear. And he was looking like a dvitiya bhaya shankaram. He was looking like Shankara himself. And he was looking contemptuous. But then, when Ravana looked at him, Nandi seemed to have the face of a monkey. When he looked at that face, he laughed an attahasam laugh, like a rain cloud rumbling. Oh, all his 10 faces, he laughed, looking at that Nandi. Nandi, blessed Nandi, who is none other than the alter ego of Shankara, he told Rasanana, Yasmadvanarupam maam avajyaya dashanana ashani patasam kasham upahasam pramuktavan tasmad madvinisam yukta madhrupa samatejasah utpachyanti vadhartam nikulaschita vanara Yasmadvanarupam maam avajyaya dashanana. Since you have laughed contemptuously at my monkey form, monkey appearance, O Dashanana, there shall be born monkeys for the destruction of your race. Who will look like me and who will be possessed with power equal to mine. They will fight with their nails and their teeth, O cruel Dashanana. They will move as swift as thought. And they will have limitless strength and they will lust for battle. They will be like mountains having wings. They shall assemble in vast numbers and they will destroy the great pride and the physical superiority of every kind that you seem to think that you have, and you and all of them they will destroy. Kim tvidane maya shakyam hantum tvameri shatara na hantavyo hatastam bhi pudameva sukarma bhi. Kim tvidane maya shakyam. What is there for me? I could finish you right here and now, this second. I could have finished you. I can finish you. But then you are already finished. Na hantavyo hatastam bhi pudameva sukarma bhi. How can you kill somebody who is already dead? You have already been killed by your past karmas. And when he said this, the celestial kettle drums etc. started boom, 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 and all that. Showers of flower fell from the sky on Ravana. Things are not going according to Ravana's plan. Dasharana's plan. Dasharana went up to the mountain And he said, I shall approve this mountain. I shall approve this mountain of yours, O Lord the Bull, because of which the Pushpaka's way was blocked when I was riding it. Tena Prabhavena Bhava Nityam Kridati Rajavat. By what prowess does that Shankara dare to say that he is sporting here as if he is some kind of king or something? Doesn't he know, as he ought to know? Bhayasthanam upasthitam. Vinyatavyam najamite. Bhayasthanam upasthitam. Does he does not know that for him fear has come. Saying this, he had his arms around the mountain and he shook it and started rocking it violently, and the whole universe was shaken by that rocking. The gods' retainer was shaken, Parvati was shaken, she clung on to Shiva, and Shiva Hara, the chief of gods, Mahadeva, he then playfully pressed the mountain with his toe. Ravana's arms, which are pinned under the mountain, were crushed. And Ravana's ministers were amazed. And Rakshasa Ravana was howling in pain, in anger. And he was creating a din which was swimming up the entire universe. His ministers thought it was a prayer sound that Ravana was making. Indra and the other gods were going somewhere in the starry skies and they were shaken. The seas were thrown into turmoil, the mountains were rocking, and all the creatures of Yaksha, Gandharvas, Kinnaras, etc. were all wondering, what is this? What is this? And then Ravana's ministers had to do something. The king was being pressed under the mountain. They had to do something. They advised him. Maybe Maricha advised him. Toshayaswa Mahadevam Neelakantam Umapatim Tamrute Sharanam Nanyam Pashyamotra Dasharana. O Dasharana, please do something to please Mahadeva. Please do. Neelakanta, the blue one with the blue throat, Umapatin, the consort of Uma, please propitiate him. Tamrite Sharanam Nanyam. We see no refuge but for him now, O Dasharana. Please propitiate him. Humble yourself. Please make yourself humble. Take refuge in him. Take refuge in him. Please extol him. Please sing his stotram. Shankara, which has got a loving disposition, he is a very loving person. He will bestow his grace upon you if he is propitiated. Please do that. They were advising Ravana. Ravana knows good advice too when he hears them. He's got caught. He's been defeated. Eva muktastada vatyai tushtava vrishabhadvajam samabhe vividai stotrai pranamya sadashana samvatsaradhasram turutto rakshasogatam. Thus advised by ministers, he started singing the praise of the Lord of the bull flag, Pungava Ketram. Adi Shankar Bhagavatpada also had a bull flag. Institutions should have flags. Bull flag. He prostrating to him, he started singing Sama hymns, Sama Veda. And then many other hymns, many other stotras of Vividai, Stotrai, he started praising. Shivatanga Stotra Veda by Ravana, Ravana Kritam. Then you are still under pain. You are singing and doing Sama, etc. Not that he was really, his arms are stuck under that mountain. He was still being pressed playfully by Shankara. And he had to also at this time try to do some Vashchitram, etc. You are singing all that, but his arms are in pain. And he was screaming also in between, and howling in pain. And then also trying to sing Stotram. And this went on for 1,000 years. So mess around with Shankara, 1,000 years, nothing but Shankara. He didn't keep it a million years. 1,000 years, you're shouting and praying, this thing, that thing going on. Then after 1,000 years, the powerful Lord, the great God, Lord Shiva was pleased. He released his arms. And he told him, Agastya is telling Rama, O Rama, then Shiva told him, I am pleased, O Dasharana, to see your extraordinary strength. displayed in the, and that fright, in the strength that you displayed in that frightful roar of yours. When the mountain was crushing your hands, the frightful roar that you let off, that pleased me.
Yasmālokatrayam chaita dravitam bhayam agatam tasmātvam rāvano nāmanāmna rājan bhavishyati.
Because of your rāvi, in the rāva, Tamil also rāva means shouting. Because of your roaring, lokatrayam bhayam agatam, because the fear was struck, the entire three worlds. Because of that, tasmātvam rāvano nāmanāmna. Therefore, you shall hereafter be known by the name of Ravana, O king. So the name Ravana was given to Ravana by Lord Shiva. Not many people know. I had an Uber car. Driver Ravana is coming, sir. Chennai. There. Some people keep Ravana. It's not uncommon. Here and there they keep. But they don't know the Shiva completely.
I think it's kept more as a anti.
Yeah, but if they know Shiva completely, they will not. But Shiva yeah, only gave the name Ravana to Ravana. Pleased with this. Stotrams, etc. So God, all who live in this world, O Ravana, the gods, the men, the yakshas and all else, shall now call you Ravana, because you have made the words vain. You may go now, O Paulastya, without a care, any route you prefer, go where you want. I give you free leave, O ruler of Rakshasas. Then Ravana, just told by Shambhu, he prayed to Shambhu saying, Shambhu, if you are pleased with me, give me a boon. I beg of thee. Suddenly, if you go to somebody big, you should also boon. Something. then only they also feel good. Give a boon. So I asked for boon. He said, Shambho, I have won immunity from death at the hands of gods, Gandharvas, Yakshas, Kindaras, Bhujyakas, Nagas, etc. And I think of men as nothing, I regard as nothing, I don't ask. Brahma has granted me, he also granted me long life, length of years. O Tuprataka, Brahma has granted me length of years, O Shiva, please bless me, that I should live out the full term that has been assured to me. 5 years have been elected, 5 years, full election. I should serve. Please grant me the full term that has been assured to me. Some bhayam is there inside that all these boons and all is fine. But to get one further reinsurance that that's okay. You will live long. So he's got that. So that's what he asked. And then he asked, that's not the only thing he asked. He also says, I'd also like to get some shastram from you. Some celestial weapon to please give me. Shankara gave him a blazing sword named Chandrahasa. And he assured him that he will live out the full term of life granted to him. That fellow is going to be born as Hanuman soon. Shiva, that is a separate thing. But he assured him full term.
He could have asked something about those monkeys, no?
Huh?
He has been born.
Shambhu told him, he gave him Chandrahasa. Huh? What did you say?
He could have asked something.
Yes,
now he's being warned by Nandi.
He
could have asked freedom from those monkeys.
Yeah, he's got. I think only men he's not asked.
No, he's No, no, but these monkeys are going to come and destroy him. Suddenly,
don't destroy him.
Only his kula. He's only worried about himself, his death.
No.
Kula, okay.
So in Chandrahasa again, when he tells him also, warns him, Ravana, don't treat this sword which can't disregard. Just treat it with all respect. If any lack of respect is shown to this sword, it will come back to me.
Good. Very nice.
He's got very valid Ravana, who had now received the name from the great God himself. He made his prostrations to him and got into the Pushpaka and went around roaming all over the world, smashing Kshatriyas right, left and center. Many Kshatriyas, very powerful, very valiant, who lust for battle, who would not want to do his will, they all perished along with their following. But then some other Kshatriyas who knew that discretion is a better part of valor, they took the path which wise men would approve. So they acknowledged defeat at the hand of the Rakshasa, who was arrogant and conscious of his strength. Sakara Ravana, of mighty arm, he was journeying all over the world and he came to a flank of Himalayas, O king, says Agastya to Rama, Tatra Pashyat Savai Kanyam, Krishna Jina Jatadara, Arshena Vidina Yuktam, Dipyantim Devatamiva. There is all suddenly a Kanya. Krishna Jina Jatadara, she had matted hair, she was clad in deer skin, Arshena Vidina Yuktam, and she was applying herself in the manner of rishis. Dipyantim Devatamiva, she was shining like a goddess. Tadishtva Rupa Sampannam Kanyam Tam Sumuhavratam Kama Moha Parit Atma Paprachya Prasanniva. He saw that Rupa Sampannam, extremely beautiful Kanya. Sumahavratam, she was observing some Mahavratam, and he was Kamavoha Paritapa, he was completely infatuated, and he spoke to her, he started laughing. When he saw her like this, my laughter, he asked her, Kimisam Vartase Bhadre Viruddham Yauvanasyate Nahi Yukta Tavetasya Rupasya Ivam Pratikriya. What are you living like this for, Bhadre? Completely doing violence to your youth. This is not worthy, this is not correct what you are doing, Bhadre. You are denying yourself what is due to you, who is one of such good looks. Rupam te anupamam bhiru kamon madakaram nunam nayuktam tapasistatam nirgato yesha nirnayah. Rupam te anupamam bhiru, oh beautiful one, your beauty is unmatchable, anupamam. Kamon madakaram nunam, it is one such as to make a man mad. Unmadakaram, with kama. It is not proper to subject yourself to such austerities. What you are doing is wrong. And that is the settled opinion of the wise. Kasya sikimidam bhadre. Whose daughter are you? Kascha bharta varanane. Who's your husband? Yena sambhujya se bhiru sanara punya bhag bhavet. Who is your husband? Who is assuredly the most blessed person in this world? Prichyata shamsame sarvam kasya heto upanishramah. Tell me, I am anxious to know, for whose sake are you taking all this trouble? Not much. He just spoke two, three verses he has spoken. When he comes to Sita later, he speaks a chapter like this. So many. He showers her. 20-30 verses he showers on her. Full poet in comparison. Just two verses on that until he, not under, when he, to Sita he had said,
Charusmite, Charudati, Charunetre, Vilasini, Manoharasime, Rame, Nadi Kulamuambhasa. Charusmite, a beautiful smile, Charudante, beautiful teeth, Charunetre, beautiful eyes. Vilasini, oh, you sporting one. Manoharasi, you are captivating my heart. Nadi Kulamuambhasa, as if a river comes and just make, a river goes to a land and it just takes over that land and makes that land collapse. Like that you are making me collapse. Nadi kulam vam masa. Like that you are doing. Varam malyam varam gandam varam vatram cha shobhane vartaram cha varam anye tvadyuktam asidekshane varam malyam. That garland is blessed which is upon you. That perfume is best which adorns you. That dress is the world's best which you wear. That husband is the greatest who's yours. Asitekshane, oh you of sword-like eyes, says to Sita, says Ravana. So now he's saying same thing. Your husband, most blessed man in the world, whoever it is, he's telling. This young lady who we saw doing tapasya in the flanks of the Himalaya, on that note we'll conclude here today and continue, start next week. Oh, we have? We're done, right?
Four, 5 minutes.
4-5 minutes? Okay. Ushadvajo. So this she was just questioned like this. She was a maid of good repute. She was rich in tapasya. She was alone doing some tapasya. Like Sita had done, she also offered him hospitality, etc., as would be given to the Madhiti who has come. She did that and then spoke to him, replied to him. Kushadvajo nama pita brahmarshir ramita prabha brihaspati sutah shreemar buddhya tulyo brihaspati. My father's name is Kushadvaja. He is a brahmarshi and of limitless luster, ramita prabha. He is the fortunate son of Brihaspati and he is equal to the Brihaspati himself in his intellect. Tasyaham kurvato nityam vedabhyasam mahatmanah sambhuya vangmai kanya namna vedavati smita. Tasyaham kurvato nityam vedabhyasam. That Mahatma, my father, by his daily abhyasa of the Veda, because of his daily recital of the Veda, I was born. I was born as the embodiment of all the Vedic learning of his. And my name is Vedavati. And I would like to tell you that the gods, the Gandharvas, the Yakshas, the Rakshasas, the Pandavas, all of them have gone and applied to my father for my hand in marriage. But my father would not give me to any of them. And I tell you why. O you of mighty arm, my father had made up his mind that Vishnu and Vishnu alone, the Lord of the three worlds, he alone should be my son, should be his son-in-law. None other. And he would give me to no one else. And one king of Daitya, known as Dambu, became so angry, he went one night and he killed my father. When he was asleep. Thereupon, my grief-stricken mother, the blessed mother of mine, she entered the fire hugging my father's body. I then resolved that I should do what is needed to keep my father's vow. Regarding Narayana, and therefore I have kept Narayana enshrined in my heart. Having walked to this effect, I am practicing severe tapasya in order to win Narayana. And now I have told you everything, O first of Rakshasas. Narayano mama pati. Natvanyaha purushottama. Not anybody else than Narayana can be my husband. I have told you that. Vinyadastvam himerajan gachapaulasthya nandana. Jana mitapasa sarvam traulokye yaddhi vartate. I know you, King.
I know you. I know you, O King, please go away. Please go away, O son of Pulastya, Paulastya. Janami tapasa sarvam trayokye yaddi vartase. By my tapasya, I know everything, the three words. On that note, we'll conclude.
Arnama Parati Pate
Arnama Mahadeva
Janaki Kanta Smaranam
Jai Jai Rama Rama
Gopika Jeevana Smaranam
Govinda Govinda
Yel Murganath
Araroha
Sadguru Swaminah
Jai